is Shell with Creative Shell Bear, and today we're going to make a thank you card using watercolor. And I have to tell you about these watercolors. They are from Color Art, and they are really shimmery. They're called Twinkling H2Os, and I just think they're absolutely gorgeous. When we get done, you'll have a real shiny effect on your watercolor page. So the three colors I'm using are Sunflower, Olive Vine, and Ginger Peach. And what you want to do when you get these is you want to go ahead and add some water to each of them so that it activates them. And you want it to kind of set for about 5 or 10 minutes or however long you want just to get the intense color. For this first layer of color, we're just going to put some, just a background down. And what we're going to do is we're going to use like a Gerber Daisy, and we're going to come back and emboss that. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to wet my surface, and this is Tim Holtz watercolor cardstock. So you just want it really good and wet, because I don't want a lot of color since this is the background. So I'm just going to dip into my Olive Vine and just kind of touch around on my page just to kind of give it a little bit of, you know, movement. And if your page is really wet, it'll kind of, if your page is really wet, it will just blend in and give you some good color. So I'm just going to do the same with the Sunflower. Again, I don't want tons of color on here. Just, this is going to be like a background. So we just want it really good and wet. Kind of like that. You just want it just a background. You want it kind of light because our focus will be the daisies. Okay, I'm going to add just a little bit more green because it's like we're looking down at the ground, and so we need some grass and stuff in there. I don't know if you can see it yet or not, but there is such beautiful shimmer in these H2Os. I think they are so pretty. It's really shimmery. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to go away, and I'm going to dry this, and I will be right back. Okay, and that's all dry now, and it has a little bit of blooming around the corners, but that's okay. That doesn't bother me. It kind of looks like it's a really neat frame, so. Okay, so it's all dry. I am using my Gerber Daisy stamp that I have shown in a previous haul, and we're going to just use some white embossing, and we're going to emboss it. Okay, so I'm going to do one in the center, and then I'm going to do one on either side, kind of down a little bit. Then we're going to go ahead and emboss those before we add the others. And I'm just leaving it on my board, taped down to my board, so that when I come back and finish my watercolor, you know, I don't have to tape it back down. So that's why I'm just leaving it where it is. And I'm just using some Zing white embossing powder. Okay, and that looks pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and emboss that. You can't see it very well right now, but you will be able to in a minute. I'm going to let that cool just a minute while I clean up. Okay, and now I need to mask off these three. So I'm just using some more blue tape, and I'm just going to tear it like into that shape and just mask it off. The thing is, you just want to make sure that it's, you know, the same size. You don't want it like too long over your flower, because if you do, then you won't have a good picture. And then I'm just going to put it on my t-shirt just to kind of take some of the sticky off so it doesn't mess up my I'm going to do that once more for this side over here. And then we'll just use these same pieces of tape to mask off in different areas. I just had the tape handy and I thought, you know, that will work just as well, and it really does, so I don't have any issues with using it as long as you're, you know, it's pretty close. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and use my VersaMark, and I'm going to put one right here. Then I'm just going to remove my tape, and I'm going to mask this side off over here. And this side. Right here. I'm going to do another one. Okay, and I'm going to remove my little masks. Our twinkling H2Os, and we're going to fill in the I'm gonna put those out of the way. We're gonna fill in our Gerber daisies, and this is just a fun, you know, just a fun way to kind of use your colors and stuff. I'm gonna use some of the ginger peach, and I'm just going to color in my daisies. Might want just a little extra water if you want it, you know, so it's not too dark. You can always come back and add more color. But I got these colors from a birthday giveaway on YouTube, and it was really fun for me. I got got them today. So I thought, well, I'll play with them, and this is kind of what I came up with. And Gerbers are my absolute favorite flower. I used to be a florist, and when I discovered Gerber daisies, I was in heaven. So I've always just adored them. So I had to get this stamp when I found this Gerber daisy stamp, and I thought, that'll be really fun. So now I'm just going to color in my flowers, give them some color, just like a field of daisies. If you've ever seen Gerber daisies, they come in multiple colors, and every time I see them, I think of God. You know, how could anyone just give us so many beautiful colors? So I just think it's so awesome, you know, that anytime I see just bright, beautiful colors, I always give the credit to God, because, you know, He made this beautiful world that we're in. Okay, and it's okay if some of the background shines through. Again, my intent was to have the background kind of shine through, or to, you know, be like a background full of daisies. I think it worked out pretty well. I think it's beautiful. And again, these twinkling H2O's by Color Art are just so gorgeous. And I am not affiliated with them. I just love the I'm loving these watercolors. If you haven't got any, I encourage you to go there and check them out. If you like shimmer and, you know, glitter and stuff without the mess. Okay. I think I'm going to go ahead and do a yellow one over here. So I needed a few thank you cards, so I decided I would just go ahead and make a few today. Just so fun to create. Okay, so I'm going to let this dry, and then I will decide if I want to add more color. So I'm going to dry that. Okay, I'm going to add just a touch of the orange just around the inside edge of the sunflower, just around each of the yellow ones, just to kind of give it a little something. And kind of fill in some of the inside too. Isn't that pretty? I just, like I said, I just love all the multiple colors. I think this was a 12 pack that I got. And some gorgeous colors. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and pick up some of the green. The olive vine. And just put that on my orange ones. A little bit more of the Okay, so I got the colors put in, and now I am just removing the tape, and we're going to make our card. Isn't that beautiful? Let's see if I can bring it up so you can see the shimmer. Isn't that just beautiful, all the shimmery and shine of that? So I'm going to get my stuff for the card, and I'll be right back. Okay, so what I did is I cut down my watercolor, and I think it is so cute. So we're going to go ahead and attach that to this green background. I just thought the green made it all really pop. So we're going to do that, and I'm just using some double stick tape. You could use foam tape or, you know, wet adhesive if you wanted to. This is just what I had on hand right now. So, okay, I'm gonna just pull that off. Okay, and then we're just going to attach it to our card base. And this is just an A2 size card base. Just going to go ahead and put my tape there. Okay, and we're just going to make sure it's on the right side, because that would be me. And I'm just going to line it up the best I can before sticking it down. And there we go. Isn't that beautiful? So if you're interested in learning more about these, be sure and visit Linda Ann Smith's channel. She works with these constantly. And again, they have the most beautiful sheen. Isn't that gorgeous? So I'm really proud to own a set of these, and I think I'll really, you know, enjoy them for years to come. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it, and you guys have a great day.